Welcome to The Tonight Show, everybody. You're here. You guys, I am so pumped about this. Tiger Woods is my guest tonight. And to make him feel comfortable, I personally carried his bag from the airport. Well, a lot of people don't know this, but combined, Tiger and I have been featured on a Wheaties box 14 times. Oh. Tiger, 14 times, and me, is there, but I'm working. Well, speaking of full-time golfers, former President Trump was back in court today for his hush money trial, and before entering the courtroom, he once again complained about the temperature and called it a freezing cold ice box. Every day slowly turning into your grandma.
Is there a draft? I hate drafts. Yeah.
He said it was an ice box. Even Biden's like, it's called a freezer, you old man. You could tell Trump was freezing today when he wrapped his tie around his neck like a scarf. Yeah, Trump was so cold he came this close to hugging Eric for warmth. I thought that was nice. Yeah. I saw that. I saw that today Eric actually attended the trial.
Ooh.
Yeah, oh, I forgot to tell you guys. Today was take your kid to court day. So it earlier. Here's a sketch of Eric in court. Yeah. And then Eric said to the sketch artist, can you draw one of me riding a skateboard with buck teeth? Of course, everyone's been talking about how Trump keeps falling asleep during his trial. And today he dozed off several more times. Eventually, Trump's lawyer just slipped a pair of those fake awake glasses on him and they I'm paying attention. Meanwhile, today the judge held Trump in contempt and fined him $9,000 for violating his gag order 9 times. And Trump was like, but I get the 10th one free, right? Trump wasn't alone when they started talking about his night with Stormy Daniels. Everyone gagged. That's right. Trump owes $9,000. He's like, that's like 8 NFTs, 9 pairs of gold sneakers, and 50 Bibles. How am I gonna pay that off? But this was nice. The judge also said that he won't hold the trial on May 17th so Trump can attend his son Barron's high school graduation. Yeah. Let me tell you, after sitting outside through a 9-hour graduation ceremony in Florida, he's gonna miss that air conditioning. Yes. Oh, and this photo of Trump walking into court after lunch is going viral. Take a look at this. Yeah, this is... this is when he tried chipmunking McNuggets back into the courtroom. Well, switching gears, some business news. Walmart just announced that they're closing all of their health care clinics. Great, now I'm gonna have to get my prostate exams at TJ Maxx. For some reason, people didn't like being vaccinated by a 90-year-old Walmart greeter with a shaky hand. It's like, you're aiming at my eyeball. What's happened? I didn't even know Walmart had healthcare clinics. It's like Krispy Kreme announcing they're no longer offering Pilates classes. Do you guys see this? Dave & Buster's is gonna start allowing customers to bet on arcade games. Until now, the only way to gamble at Dave & Buster's was to eat there. Some more business news, Domino's just launched a new promotion that tips customers who tip their delivery drivers. Yeah, so they're giving customers money to give their drivers money. If only there were a simpler way. I don't think there is. You guys, today is the last day of April. I thought it'd be nice to give a little recap of the entire month. Here, let's do a quick one. Thank you. Thank you.
April's done, it felt so short. Time flew by except in court. One guy sat there every week, yeah.
Donald Trump fell asleep.
We all looked up at the sun with our glasses, it was fun. Walk atop a full eclipse, how about
the latest album from Taylor Swift?
Caitlin Clark is MVP, Challenger's the top movie. Tennis stars behaving bad, don't watch it with
mom and dad.
Month of April, there was plenty. Earth Day, Tax Day, and 420. Also April Fools, of course. I wish that explained.
The first Golden Bachelor couple is getting a divorce.
It was the fourth month of the year, and now it's done, the next one's here. The only thing that's left to say is that
it's gonna be May.
There you go. All right, thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much. Appreciate that. Thank you, Ruth. It's gonna be May. Finally, guys, the Kentucky Derby is this Saturday, which means that it's time once again for Kentucky Derby Hat Week. Here we go.
Kentucky Derby Hat Week. Kentucky Derby Hat Week. Kentucky Derby Hat Week.
Every show this week, we're partnering with Ford to give one lucky audience member a riz-tacular Kentucky Derby hat. From the Derby hat starting gate, since this is day two, let's open gate number two and see what hat we're doing. I see it. Ready? One, two, three. Wow. That is a beautiful hat right there. That is a great Kentucky Derby hat. Now let's see who's going home with tonight's hat. Everyone look at your seat number. And if I call your number, I need you to jump up, let me know where you are, and you have to stand up because you have to try this on. All right, Quest, can I get a drum roll, please? Who wants this hat? Come on. $298. Where are we going? Where are we going? To see you. Welcome to the show.
Thanks.
What is your name and where are you from?
Anna, Dutchess County.
Hey, Anna, Dutchess County. Very good. Anna, I realize you didn't want to stand up to win this beautiful hat. You're just in shock.
This is a lot of anxiety.
Yeah, actually. It's a lot. Yeah, no pressure. There's no pressure. Do you have a hat like this for Kentucky Derby?
No.
You don't. So this is the first one like this. Would you like to try it on right now?
Sure, of course.
You guys, I think it'll be. You look beautiful. That's fantastic. No one will have a hat like you. I have to help you keep it up. Try to keep it on the whole show. No, I'm just kidding. Right. Thank you so much. Congratulations to our winner. A round of applause, please. Thank you to everyone at Ford. Be sure to enter their Derby Day sweepstakes when you have a chance to win a brand new vehicle of your choice, an all-new electric Ford Mustang Mach-E, EcoBoost Power Bronco, or F-150 Power Boost Hybrid. We'll be right back with more Tonight Show, everybody. Come on back.